Hi everybody, today I wanted to share with you my progress on the candy box journal that I have been working on. And if you watched my previous video, you saw the beginning stages of this journal where I talked about how I was actually putting it together. So I've done some work on it and I feel that there is a lot more to do, but at this point it is worthy of sharing with you a bit of a flip in a new video. So here we are, and that's what I'm doing today in this video. So you'll see before you the candy box journal, and I'm really loving how it's turning out. I love the braided ribbon that I've attached to part of the binding, as well as the beads and the organza ribbon and sari ribbon that I've added. I think it's really gorgeous. And I've tied it also with, I changed out the ribbon originally. I had this kind of organza ribbon in the first video that I was tying the book together with, but I changed it out and decided to go with the sari ribbon here that you see before you. And this is actually a mock sari ribbon, and the reason I say mock sari is because it is truly not made from saris. It is a handmade piece of ribbon that my friend Robin actually came up with this idea, and it's so simple that you can do this yourself with any leftover fabric that you might have. So for example, this is some silk that she had, but it's not from a sari. It's actually silk that she had lying around from extra projects. So you could do this with anything. You could do this with cotton fabric. You could do it with leftover muslin, any kind of fabric that you have that tears well and has somewhat of a ragged edge, because that's the look that you're going for. You want something with a ragged edge to sort of emulate what sari ribbon looks like. So with that being said, I thought that this would make a great addition to, and I love the touch of it. As you can see, I keep playing with it while I'm chatting. I love the feel of it. It just feels so good. And then I've also added this adorable little floral embellishment, which I wrapped with some floral tape right here. And this is the look of the inside of the book, how it's coming along, and as you can see, it's getting to be quite chunky. And those of you that know me know that I love the look of chunky journals, and I also love making chunky journals. So here's another view. And I've added, in addition, some planner clips that I've created, as well as colored paper clips to add as tabs in turning the pages. I think it's really neat how that came out. So let's get into this, and I'm going to undo the ribbon and share with you all this yumminess. So here we go. And this is the inside. And I've added some cutouts from magazines. I've painted inside here. I've added some die cuts to create what you're going to see thus far. And I also made this cute little planner clip right here, which is just a piece of organza ribbon on top of a decorative clip. I love the way that looks. And here we go inside. I've yet to paint. I want to paint inside here with the page that I wrote, Creative Courage. And here's the flip through. So as you can see, I've painted and added some die cuts. This is some handmade paper that I dye. I added that to this page along with some three-dimensional star stickers and another die cut. Some more die cuts here as we flip through. And this is one of my rose planner clips right here, resin roses. And one of my Miladyleela tags. Some more die cuts. angel wings. And I just love the look of these painted papers. Some beautiful stickers. And a fortune. A fortune cookie. Which I thought was kind of cute because this is all about how to use chopsticks. So as you can see, I have a lot more to do. I'll be able to add more things or write some notes, maybe some poetry. And then in this signature right here, there is a bunch of colored notepapers throughout this entire section of the signature, so I can handwrite things, take notes and such. And once again, in this section of this signature, there's a bunch of colored notepaper to write notes and things in. Lots of paper there that I can do things on and doodle and such. And here's another little planner clip that I've created. And incidentally, these planner clips that I make, these and the roses, they are available for purchase. So if anybody's interested in owning one of these, then just let me know and I can chat with you and let you know pricing and such. And then this is a piece of sari ribbon. This is actually a real sari ribbon that I received from an Etsy seller. And these are little pockets here inside. And I've tucked in a piece of paper so that I can jot notes on. That goes. It's got the little pocket. And then getting to the end of the book, here's another bits of my handmade dyed paper that I do on this pocket. And again, some notes, a little card that says hugs and kisses, which is actually a little Valentine card. And then another piece of note paper tucked in to write on. Lots of places to write. And the last page is my hand-dyed paper and then a beautiful embellished sticker that says treasure. And this is the last page. And then I also have tucked in here, look how cute this is. This was actually in a drink. And it was a stir in a drink and a decorative accent to a cocktail. And I thought it was really sweet, so I put it inside this journal. And this was actually a little gifty from Robin also. She and I and the hubbies went out for dinner. And she had ordered some sort of a cocktail. And they added this in, and she gave it to me. And it fits absolutely perfect as a page marker inside my candy box journal. And here's the back page. So I'm loving how this looks. I'm going to tie it back up for you once again to show you how wonderful it is and how it looks again tied. And you don't have to tie it real tight if you don't want to. I mean, I really love the chunkiness. These are so fun to make. It is literally made out of a snow cap candy box that I got at the Dollar Tree. But you could probably get them at the grocery store. Also, I've seen them there for a dollar. And candy boxes come in all different sizes, so you could create one any size you want, but I really like the look of this. I thought it was kind of like an address book size. Although there are some address books that are a little bit thicker or wider, shall I say, but I just thought that this was so cute and I love the look. So anyways, that is that. And I hope you've enjoyed this video and I hope it inspires you to create one of your own. And keep in mind that if you are interested in having me hand make a journal for you, then I can do that too. just drop me a message and let me know, and we can talk about what it is that you are looking for, and I'd be more than happy to put one together for you. I work pretty much intuitively when I create journals. That if you're interested in having me make a journal for you from scratch, unless it's one that you've seen that I've already created that I'm offering available for purchase, my journals that I would create for you once you ask me to do one, which is like a commissioned piece, I work intuitively. So basically, you would tell me what it is that you are looking for. You would tell me some of the colors that you are interested in, some of the themes that you might be interested in, and I would go ahead and intuitively put together a journal for you that I felt was I was being called to do specifically for you. So I can do that as well if you're interested. Just let me know. Otherwise, you can always create one for yourself. They're very, very simple and so much fun. So thanks for watching this video. I hope I have inspired you to create one of your own, because it truly is a fun art project to do, and it's something that you can continue to work on and add to and just put your own creative spin and intentions into also. With that being said, I hope you're having a lovely and magical day, and I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Many blessings, friends. Talk to you soon. Bye-bye.